Brad Johnson here from johnson.audio, and today I'm going to answer the question, what is phantom power? Phantom power is going to be a 48 volt charge of direct current that goes through your balanced cable from your preamp to power a condenser microphone. Condenser microphones have internal amplifiers and they need that extra current to be able to get the sound out of it. If you hook up a condenser microphone to a preamp without phantom power, you're not going to get a signal. Or you're gonna get a very, very, very weak signal. You could try to boost the gain on your preamp and you might start to see some signal, but you need that phantom power. Now there's a few things you need to understand about phantom power. First of all, it is an additional 48 volts of direct current that is going through your cable into your microphone. And so you have to understand that if you have this extra current going through, there's a thing called hot swapping that if you were to unplug the microphone or if you were in a patch bay and you wanted to switch preamps, but you had that additional current going on, when you break that current, you could fry your preamp. You can also ruin your microphone. So you have to be aware that you must plug in your mic first, then turn on phantom power, and then turn off phantom power before you do any kind of disconnection with any kind of cabling. This is very, very important. When I first started working with my own productions years ago, I actually did fry one of my preamps doing this. So this is from personal experience. Please do not do it. It is a bad thing to do. Next thing you need to know about phantom power is that it is meant for condenser microphones. Condensers used to be powered by external power units, and eventually they decided that, you know, when they were recording with all these different condenser microphones, they had all these external power supplies. They ended up figuring out how to rig up extra power from the console to send out to their microphones, thus phantom power being created. Now that's just the simple version of explaining it, but you have to understand now that it's not meant for a dynamic microphone. It's not meant for a ribbon microphone. So you don't need it for those microphones. If you have phantom power on with a dynamic microphone, you're gonna be fine. It won't ruin the microphone, but now with ribbon microphones, if you send an additional 48 volts of current to a ribbon microphone, the ribbon is very delicate and you can actually ruin the ribbon microphone. Now, if you're in a studio and you're using, you know, a Royer that's $1,000 plus ribbon microphone and you put phantom power on it and you ruin it, you're gonna have a very, very angry studio owner. If you have that microphone yourself and you ruin it, you're gonna be a very bummed microphone owner. So just know you do not need 48 volt phantom power for a ribbon microphone or a dynamic. It is only for condensers. And another thing to note, and this is for if you actually go to a studio and you're working on a console, some consoles have a switch for 48 volts that will go across all channels. So you have to be aware if you're trying to mic up, say, a drum set, if you have ribbon microphones, say you have a nice set of Coles that are your overheads, and then you go, oh, I have a condenser microphone for my hi-hat mic, or I have it for a kick out, and then you go, okay, and you flip on that 48 volts, you might blow out those Coles, and that is something that would be a big bummer. Those are expensive microphones. Again, you're going to have a very angry studio owner. So these are the things that you just have to know about 48 volts. Phantom power is that you do not disconnect when it's engaged, because you could fry your preamp, you could fry your microphone, and it's not a good thing. Also, do not use it for ribbons, do not use it for dynamics. That is the basics of 48 volts. It seems like a very basic thing, and it is a basic thing, but one quick story I like to share with you that's kind of funny and also sad at the same time is I worked for a producer who had an intern who graduated from recording school, and when he was working in the studio, he did not understand the basics of phantom power. I don't know which audio school he went to. I don't know if he skipped that day, but it should be common knowledge. It should be something that you know. It's not that difficult, and I hope this video helped you. If it did, please give me a thumbs up. It is much appreciated. Please leave me a comment, also letting me know that you learned something from this, or maybe your experiences with blowing up a preamp one time in your past. Even as embarrassing it is, I've done it. So let me know if you've done it so I don't feel alone and stupid in this. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. I am here to help you sing your story, mix your mission, and master your message. For all the other subscribers out there, I appreciate your continued support. Again, my name is Brad Johnson, johnson.audio, and I will see you on the next video. Bye.